Welcome to Research Business Daily Report, where market researchers come for news, insights, and commentary about their research fields. Information, knowledge, and insights, plus commentary that impacts them both inside and outside their current place of work. On RBDR today, half of marketers are predicting the death of the cookie by 2018. Why? Stick with us and we'll tell you why. And next, polling industry awards, only the satirical kind that most of the recipients probably are not going to be happy about receiving. RBDR is sponsored today and this week by Symmetric Sampling, a division of decision analysts providing sampling services to companies that place a very high value on representative samples, scientific sampling methods, and advanced fraud detection systems. You'll be able to learn more through a link that we'll be sending to you at the end of today's report. An estimated, and if accurate, jaw-dropping $7.2 billion was supposedly wasted on fraudulent advertising during the past year. But something of a partial solution may already be in place. Viant, a Time Incorporated company, surveyed 251 UK brand marketing managers and discovered that many digital marketers have already turned away from cookie-based campaigns and instead are opting for people-based marketing. Now, one immediate benefit of that is reaching individuals across all of their mobile and tablet devices and tracking digital information in offline sales. If marketers had any doubt about the best option between the two, it's probably dissipated. 83% of these marketers say people-based marketing performs better than cookie-based campaigns simply because of improved targeting and reaching those targets. With two-thirds of smartphone and tablet devices no longer accepting cookies, that accessibility is most important. A lot of you may be familiar with the annual Golden Raspberry Awards, or Razzies, that recognize the year's worst in film. And the group makes it a point to select Hollywood's biggest stars to lampoon. Well, I was unaware before this weekend that the polling industry has its own tongue-in-cheek awards, which in fact are in their ninth year. Gallup and Pew, two of the biggest names in polling, just received the year's top honor from this organization for their most questionable actions in media polling. The issuing organization is iMediaEthics. The choices are made by its director of polling, David Moore, who is a senior fellow with the University of New Hampshire School of Public Policy. He's also a former Gallup vice president. iMediaEthics is published by not-for-profit Art Science Research Laboratory and annually selects 10 polling award winners, or losers. As mentioned, the top prize this year, the Fear of Failing honor, was shared by Gallup Organization's James Clifton and Pew Research Center's Michael Dymock for deciding not to conduct pre-election polling during 2016. Now, the eight other quote-unquote award winners, the Counting Chickens Before There's Even a Rooster honor was bestowed on public policy polling for already deciding to poll about the 2020 presidential election. The Inciting Holiday Hostility Award went to the Public Religion Research Institute for its poll that claims Republicans and Democrats are polar opposites on the phrases Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. Then there's the Reading Tea Leaves Award. It was shared by Associated Press and NORC for biased polling on the presidential nominating process. And finally, the Gilding the Lily Award went pretty widespread to the CBS News and New York Times pollsters, CNN and ORC, Bloomberg, and Quinnipiac for their polling on Merrick Garland's never seriously considered Supreme Court nomination. That's your Research Business Daily Report, which has been sponsored today and is this week by Symmetric Sampling, a division of Decision Analyst, providing sampling services to companies that place a very high value on representative sample scientific sampling methods and advanced fraud detection systems. You can and you should take advantage of the opportunity to learn more by going to SymmetricSampling.com. We hope you have a great research day, and of course, be back here and visit us again tomorrow.